for worship one more time. Hallelujah. We're going to get ready to start church. And we're going to give Jesus all the honor, glory, and praise that belongs to him. Amen. Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, bow down heads and humble heart. Thank you, Lord, for the many blessings you are showering upon us right now. We ask you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, to bless those who are trying to make it here to church, but they make it here safe and sound. Bless those traveling up and down the dangerous highway, but they be able to make it to their destination. Father, we ask you, Lord, to bless and anoint this church service this morning. Bless the man of God, that he bring forth your holy word under the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost. We ask you, Lord, to bless the congregation to sing under your anointing and power of the Holy Ghost. Without your power, your Holy Ghost, Lord, we are lost. We can do nothing. We ask you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, to bless those that are going through bereavement right now, Lord, help them to realize earth had no sorrow, heaven cannot heal. Jesus, we need you. We can't make it in this world without you. Father, we ask you, Lord, to bless those that are sick and shut in. Touch, Father, with your finger of healing and raise them off of the sick bed and help them to realize, Father, that they can depend on you. Lord, we're not going to forget those that are behind prison walls. We ask you to bless them. They can hear your holy words behind those walls. And Father, we have so much hatred and malice going on in the world today, but God, we know that you is love. You're sending your holy word. If we love one another, the world will know that we are your disciples. Father, we ask you to bless those that are devastated by the tornadoes and natural disasters and the shooting all over this world, Father. Seeing like every week or every other day there's a shooting, Lord. Lord, give us the strength to make it day by day. And bless us, Father, with that love that flows from heart to heart and mind to mind. Jesus, we realize that your word is true. And every man's word is alive. Your word say, if we trust in you, everything will be all right. And Lord, we believe your word. You say it in your word. If your word abide in us and we abide in your word, we can ask what we will and it shall be done unto us. We ask you right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, to protect us, Lord, from all hurt, harm, and danger. And Lord, we see that Satan is working towards our babies, our little ones, all in the schoolhouse. They're not even saved. But Lord, cover them with your blood. Cover them with your divine protection, Father. You said in your holy word, Father, anyone hurt one of these little ones, it'd be best for him to take a millstone around his neck and throw himself in the middle of the sea. Lord, we ask you for your grace and for your mercy, Lord. Bless this nation, Father. And the blessing you see we stand in need of. Lead us and guide us, Father, in the direction you will have us to go, Father. Your way, Father, is the only way. Lord, have mercy, Father. Father, this is your servant prayer. In your son Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah.
Even though we got sin and hatred and all kind of foolishness all around us, we still can lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah! All right, officer, come on, let's have divine praise and worship. Come on, come on, come on. Let's lift up the name of Jesus.
I don't think y'all heard what Elder Barrett said. He said, come on, let's lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, let's lift up the name of Jesus. The one who died on the cross. The one who has saved your soul and my soul. Amen. The one who has done more than any friend or brother can do. Hallelujah. His name deserves the glory, honor, and the praise on today. Hallelujah. How many of y'all just glad to be in the house of the Lord one more time? Amen. 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 We thank and we praise God on today. We give him all the glory because he deserves all the glory. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So we just want to welcome you here. Amen. In this place. We welcome you into a time of worship right now. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So y'all come on and worship with us right now. Amen. We thank you, Lord, for giving us a mind to worship you and only you, because you deserve the praise. You deserve honor, the glory, and we give it all to you on today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, welcome,
yes, yes,
into this place.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome into this broken vessel you desire to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands and we lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Y'all help me sing, welcome,
welcome into this place.
Someone say, welcome,
welcome into this broken vessel you desire to abide in the praise of your people. So we lift our hands and we lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Oh, welcome. Oh, welcome into this place. How many of y'all feel welcome here on today?
Yes, indeed.
Someone say welcome.
Welcome
into this.
Into this place.
Broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your dream. So we lift our hands and we lift our as we offer up this praise unto your name. Oh, welcome,
welcome
into
this place.
Lord, you are
welcome
into this broken vessel. Somebody offer up a praise right now. Oh, as we offer up this praise, hallelujah, to your name. Hey, as we offer up this praise unto your name. Hallelujah. Come on, give him praise right now. Give the Lord praise. He deserves it. Amen. Amen. We're going to move forward with this worship experience as we get a line. Brother Reese and scripture. Okay, so Deacon Jones is going to line in him. We're going to have a scripture. We're going to sing that hymn, have a prayer, and then go and do another song. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
First Lady, Deaconess, members and friends. We're going to be up this morning as long as the good Lord see fit. But we're going to do as I would do like we're supposed to. We're going to line a hymn, come up with a prayer and a scripture. Our hymn this morning be coming from 304. Father, I stretch my hand to thee, for no other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, O brother, shall I go? What did that only son endure before I drew my breath? What pain, what labor to secure my soul from an endless death? The oft I fail, the day I lift my weary and lonely eyes. But before I drew my breath, my soul without a die.
Morning, church. Scripture is coming from Psalms 95. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Yeah. Let us make a joyful noise to the rocks of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with the thanksgiving and the joyful noise unto him with song. For the Lord is great.
Yes.
God. And a great king above all. God's. In his hands are the deep place of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and the making of it. And his hands form the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord. Our Maker,
yes.
I have read to you Psalms 95, 1 through 6. Let the Lord bless the word of the reading.
Let us all sing with uplifted voice this morning. Let us sing like the sun is shining out this morning. It's a beautiful morning. It's not too hot. It's not too cold. So let's sing, enjoy it this day, because tomorrow is not promised to you.
Amen.
Father, I stretch my hand to thee, for no other help I know. Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No from your seat. Father, the faith of thee I lift my weary and lonely eyes. Father,
until I die.
Dear Heavenly Father, dear Lord, we come before you right now, God, giving thanks. We thank you, Father God, for allowing us to wake up once again on this morning, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Father God, for breathing the breath of life within our lungs once again, God. We thank you for life, health, and for strength, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for allowing the blood to run warm through our veins once again, Father God.
Yes.
We thank you, God, for allowing us to be stayed in our right mind, God.
Yes, Lord.
We could have been going left. We could have been going backwards, God. We could have been going the wrong way. But, God, you allowed us to be stayed in our right mind, Father God, and we thank you. We thank you for the movement of our limbs on today, Father God. Allow us to be able to lift up our hands and praise right now, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
Allow us to be able to clap our hands, God. And just thinking about the blessings and the victory that you have for us, God. Yes. Allow us to be able to stand up on our 2 feet once again, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
To walk in the house of God one more time, Father God.
Yes.
Oh, Lord God, you are so merciful, Father God.
Yes.
You are so kind, God.
Yes.
You are just awesome right now in every way, Father God.
Yes.
You have blessed us in ways that we cannot see, Father God. From the very inner parts of our being, God, to the very outer parts of our being, God, you have blessed us, God.
Right.
Touched us and anointed us, Father God, one more time, God, to give your name all the glory, honor, and the praise, Father God. We ask, God, right now, God, that you will just continue to go before us, God.
Yes.
Making all of our crooked paths straight, Father God.
Yes.
Sometimes we try to walk down the wrong road, Father God.
Mercy, Lord.
But your Holy Spirit, Father God,
yes.
Your Holy Spirit, God, it leads and guides us in the way that we should go, Father God. We thank you for giving us your Holy Spirit, Father
yes.
God.
Yes.
Father God, continue, God, to be with us. Bless us, Father God.
Yes.
And anoint us, Father God. You have anointed us, Father God, from the day that we was born, God. You have given us an anointing, God, that only you can give and that only we can use, Father God.
Yes.
So we pray right now, Father God, that you will continue to allow us to walk within that anointing, Father God.
Yes.
To use that anointing, Father God, that you have given us, Father God, to be used for your purpose right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Father God, we just ask right now that you will just be with those, Father God, who are standing out there sick right now, Father God. Don't know which way to go. Don't know which way to turn, Father God. Might be going through this, God, sugar, diabetes, whatever it might be, Father God, heart conditions, Father God. We pray that you will touch right now, heal, deliver, and anoint them right now in the name of Jesus, Father God. Lift them up from their sick beds right now, Father God. Bring them out of that pathway, Father God, that leads only to destruction, Father God. We claim a victory in our lives right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And we thank you for it right now,
thank
Father
you.
God. Bless this church right now, Father God.
Yes.
Continue to lead us, Father God, and provide for us, Father God, as you have done so well, Father God. We thank you, God.
Thank you
right now, Father God. We lift up our hands right now, and we thank you, and we give you glory, Father God.
Yes.
And we can say nothing but giving you the highest praise, hallelujah, right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, Father God. Hallelujah, God.
Yes.
You have been so kind.
Yes.
You have just been so great, Father God. Continue to go out there and just be out there in those war-torn lands, Father God.
Yes.
We have not been in a spot, God, in our lifetime, Father God, to be in a war, Father God. But those other countries, Father God, that are going through right now, God,
yes.
We just pray right now, God, that you will be with them, Father God, that you will just stop this war, God. We know that wars are to come, Father God, but we know that when it is in your will, you can stop them at any moment, Father God. So
yes.
We're just praying until that time comes that you will just be with your people, Father God.
Yes.
Continue to keep them protected, Father God, from all hurt, harm, and danger. And we thank you, God, and we give
you
praise, God, as we lift up your name one more time, God, and we call on you, Jesus. Jesus. Somebody know that there's power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
So you just continue to call on the name of Jesus, and we will continue to call on you, Jesus. Somebody say Jesus right now in a time of sickness. Jesus right now in a time of hunger. Jesus right now in a time where there's no money in your pocket. Somebody call on the name of Jesus.
I praise the Lord.
God, we will continue to call on you, Jesus. Because we know there's power right there in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And we thank you and we praise you.
Yes.
Come on, somebody give God praise in this house right now. Somebody give God praise in this house right now. Somebody give God praise in this house right now. If you know that he is worthy of the praise, go ahead and give God praise.
Yeah.
Keep your hands together if you know he's continually worthy of that praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You have brought us again. Trouble seen and unseen. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Anybody love him on today? Anybody love him on today? Hallelujah.
Every day.
We thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. want y'all just to join together as we sing this one last song. How many of y'all truly love Jesus?
Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. If you truly love him, y'all won't mind helping us sing this song here. Simply says, oh, how I love Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo. Come on, say it. Oh, 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 how I love Jesus. Oh, 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 how I love Jesus. Oh, 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 how I love Jesus. Because. Can we say it one more time? Oh, how. Let me sing a verse, y'all. It tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's birth.
Say one,
another verse here. Oh, it tells me of my Father has in store for every day. And though I tread a darksome path, he'll sunshine all the way. Oh,
I'm
going to say one last verse. I'm going to leave it alone.
It tells of one whose loving heart can feel my deepest woe. Who in each sorrow bears a part that none can bear below.
Put them hands together, y'all.
Oh, oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, how I love.
Oh, how I love Jesus.
Oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me.
Because he first?
Because he first loved me.
Because he first loved me.
Because he
first loved me. Hallelujah.
Love.
All right.
Me.
Hallelujah. Because he first loved me. How many of y'all know that he loved us first? Amen. Come on, get a Lord one more hand clap of praise. Amen. As we prepare for the word from the man of God. Amen. Hallelujah.
Come on, let's give him another hand clap. We thank our devotional leaders, amen, for getting us going on this beautiful, beautiful first Sunday morning in the month of June. We give God glory, we give him honor, we give him praise. He is truly worthy to be praised. Come on, give him a hand clap. Hallelujah. Have a word from the Lord. It is definitely an
qualifications to work with young people. And I think I probably spent about 20 hours out of my week testing this week. And as I came this morning, the Lord just put it on my heart to take you on a journey. You know, life is a journey. Life gives you highs, it gives you lows, and sometimes we don't know how good God is. Come on, somebody. Till it's all said and done. The old preachers say we are all understanding better. Ooh, somebody heard that old preacher. Say we are understanding all better by and by. Amen. Let us bow our heads. Father, we come and we thank you. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for your Son Jesus who died on Calvary's cross to give us the right to the tree of life. We thank you for right now. Come on, somebody. We thank you for health, strength, food on our tables, clothes on our backs. Most of all, you allowed us to be clothed in our right minds to come out and to praise you, to worship you, to lift you up. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men from the earth. So we come to lift you up today, Father, and acknowledge you in all our ways. For your word says, you will then direct our paths. We thank you now, and we bless you. We ask you now to consecrate everyone in this place. Allow me to go down in your storehouse just for a little while, that I may be able to break the bread of life with your people, is our prayer. Amen. Amen. Come on, give God some praise. Oh, what a week. What a week this has been. I want you to understand that these are the last and evil days. I want you to understand this. Before I even get into the text, I want the atmosphere to be set that you will understand that time is fleeting. Time is fleeting. Man has lost it. Man has lost it. When you can watch 19 children get killed at Uvalde, Texas, and two teachers, and act like life just goes on, we've lost it. When you can see people hungry and homeless, and with mental health issues, and you defund mental health, we have lost it. But God, God gives us opportunities to use our gifts for the better of man. We oftentimes are so stuck on heaven till we forget about our value here on earth. And God is put in my spirit today to let you know that you still on the journey. We haven't arrived, but we are still on the journey. I talk to young people every day, and their mind and their eyes are so fixed on the end result until they forget to enjoy the journey. And you know, your end result doesn't come tomorrow or the next day. Your end result is a ways off. So that time between you getting there, right, and where you started from should be a time like the trip you took with mama, and we had them chicken sandwiches and the mayonnaise packs and little ice chests, and you would pull over on the side of the road and you would eat a little bit and you would fellowship with your family. This is what life should be about. Life shouldn't be about going all the way to Miami. Come on, somebody. And not receiving anything along the way. Not a sweet Florida orange, not a beautiful Florida grapefruit. I used to like the little plastic dolphins they would make at the store on the turnpike. I couldn't wait to get there. There was something to be enjoyed. And that's what I want you to know, church. There's something to be enjoyed on this Christian journey. On Bible study the other weekend, and I said, Lord, this thing is heavy. This thing is hard. You know you got enemies everywhere. You know you got people who take advantage of you. You know you got people who oppress you. But still, God wants you to have joy. And I said, God, then you got the nerve to tell us to pray for them that despitefully use us, to pray for our enemies. I said, God, how do we pray for our enemies? And as we were doing Bible study, I said, today we're going to get a breakthrough. We're going to get revelation on how to pray for your enemies. Because as a Christian, it is commanded of us. That thing hard, ain't it? It is commanded of us to pray for our enemies, to pray for those who despitefully use us. And in that Bible study, God put in our spirit, just pray for others. We get so hung up on trying to tag everything, trying to put a label on everything. God said, let me help your heart out. Think about it. Let me help your heart out. He said, when you pray for others, that's everybody outside of you. That's everybody outside of your family. Because the Bible says even the heathens pray for them that they love. What separates us is we have to pray for those who are our enemies. Now, I said that to say this. There's a new beginning for us. There's a new beginning for us. There's a new journey for us. I was so pleased this morning when I came and I saw that the fields were cut. God will send people. We all know what Deacon Jones and Sister Geneva are going through right now. And I said, I know Deke, he's dealing with his wife. I know Deke hadn't been out there to cut that. But Brother Britt, what are you saying, Lord? What are you saying, Pastor? God will send you what you need when you need. Stop being scared of the journey. Stop being scared of the journey. This morning I want to talk from the subject, don't despise small beginnings. Turn with me, and I'm going to get on out your way. Turn with me to the book of Zechariah. Thank you, Lord. Fourth chapter. 10th verse, and let this lift you from your feet, lift you from your seats, and then you'll be okay. I'll leave you alone with standing and all of that. Let it lift you. Zechariah is the next to the last book in the Old Testament. It's right in front of Michael and Matthew. If you have it, say amen. Guess nobody has it. Amen. I need an amen if I can move the train. You have it, say amen. You don't have it, say hold on. I heard a hold on. Amen. To God be the glory. I'm just amazed at what God can do with nothing. Y'all going to pray with me today. All right. So here we are, Zechariah 4 and 10. For who hath despised the day of small beginnings? For they shall rejoice and shall see the plummet in the hand of Zerubbabel with those seven. They are the eyes of the Lord which run to and fro through the whole earth. Amen. God, may God bless the readers, hearers, and doers of his word. You may be seated. Nobody is a better example of small beginnings than God. Turn with me to the book of Genesis, first chapter. Who better to teach us about small beginnings than our book tells us in Genesis 1, in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God saw the light, that it was good. This word good is important to us. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day. The evening and the morning were the first day. And God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the water, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And God made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day. Y'all gonna pray with me. And God said, let the waters under the heaven be gathered together into one place, let the dry land appear, and it was so. And God called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters called he the seas, and God saw that it was good. Come on, somebody. And God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after its kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth. And it was so. And the earth brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself after its kind, and God saw that it was. Talk to me, somebody. And the evening and the morning were the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons, and for days and years. And let them be for the lights in the firmament of heaven to give light upon the earth. And it was so. Amen. Let us look at how God operates. God designed something that was made out of nothing that was made. You can't get any smaller than a zero balance in your bank account. Come on, somebody. You can't get any smaller than just having a cup of water and a piece of bread. Been there, done that, got the t-shirt. You can't get any smaller than a syrup sandwich. Anybody ever been there? A little peanut butter and a little syrup. Talk to me, somebody. You can't get any smaller than these types of beginnings. And what we see here this morning is at the end of each day, God paused and looked at his efforts and assessed his progress. What I'm saying to the church is, day by day and week by week and month by month, you have to make time to assess your progress. And with God, your progress is going to be G-O-O-D. Your progress is going to be good. Whatever you put your hands to, the Bible says, a man is not fit for the kingdom if he puts his hand to the plow and look back. Everything that we need to do is forward. We need to press our way forward. Learn how to enjoy the process. God say, that was pretty good, if I may say so myself. There ought to be something in your life that you can look in the mirror and say to yourself, that was pretty good. Well, somebody say, that'll be bragging or being boastful, but no. Even David encourage himself. I wish somebody would go with me. David had to encourage himself in the Lord. And what I'm telling you, if you're going to make this journey, if the process is going to be good to you, amen, you got to understand that God is in charge. And if God can make something out of nothing, come on, somebody, he sure enough can take what we've got, our little bit, multiply that, bring things to pass that we never thought would come to pass. He said that was pretty good. Separate the day from night, the heavens from the earth, the water from the land. Y'all gonna pray with me? He had to stop and look at that thing. God said that was pretty good. I want the church to know the things that you're doing, the intervention, the prayers that you are sending up, the timber that you are setting up, that's pretty good. The people in Uvalde need our prayers. The nation needs our prayers. Are you going to pray with me? I want you to know that even though you're in a small place, in a small period of time, God can use you. You might be the person who can get a prayer through. The next time some 19-year-old has in his mind to shoot somebody, you might be the one to get the prayer through that when they crash in the ditch, they'll be incapacitated and they won't be able to go on and carry out that foolishness. But we got to send up some timber. We got to pray. We got to intervene for our nation. Psalms 37 and 23 say the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. God ordained and ordered the step-by-step process. What we're going through right now, God ordained this thing. Going through the steps of the creative process is part of the preparation process. When you know how you did it, you will know how to keep it. When you know how you did it, you will know how to keep it. If God did it for you, and you give him praise, and you give him glory, that's how you keep it. So you got to know how you did it. It wasn't so much that you were this or that, but God stepped in on our behalf and made it happen. We prepare to take our seat. You got to know that people that get too much too fast tend to lose. If you don't have no vested interest in something, easy come. Somebody gonna talk to me. Easy go. Yeah. If we prepare to close, you need to know that people who get too much too fast tend to lose it. When I look at Genesis 1 and 5, and God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And the evening and the morning were the first day. Somebody may be in a midnight experience. They say it's darkest just before the dawn. Somebody may be in a midnight experience. Let me help you as I close here this morning. In the book of Acts 16:25-6, it said, and at midnight, Paul and Silas, they prayed. I'm trying to give you insight into what's going to separate us from the world. What is going to strengthen us in our faith is our prayer life. Big Mama say prayer changes things. You could come in with the worst news to Big Mama, but Big Mama going to tell you the same thing. Baby, I think prayer changes. Y'all going to walk with me? Listen. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed, sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation, we got to shake the foundation with our prayers. Our prayers can shake the foundation of this nation, of this madness that's going on in our country. If we would just pray. Y'all know what the book says. The book tells us in Chronicles 7 and 14, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray. Get that? And what? And pray. Seek my face. Turn from their wicked ways. Then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal the land. The land is corrupt. The land has an infection in it. Next week. There's going to be a big show from Washington, D.C. It's going to be amazing to you. I'm trying to prepare you for this. How people see the same thing, but get a different interpretation. I don't want you to lose your mind. I don't want you to let animosity and hatred infest your heart. So before Thursday, you need to be prayed up. We have seen two impeachment hearings that were farce. We have seen from the beginning of that man's inception into politics, every race, every gender, every person who could be torn down. We've seen it. Nobody's done anything. When you up against adversaries such as this, you got to pray for others. I'm trying to help you in here. I ain't trying to preach you happy today. We're in serious times. I'm trying to prepare you for a move of God. Not a move with somebody else, but a move with you. See, we often think somebody else needs God more than we need God. Don't nobody else need God more than I need God. I need God for myself. I need a personal relationship with God. I need God to guard my heart. I need God to protect me. So God said to me to tell your people, don't look at other people. Don't point fingers, but pray for others. Because you're going to see some foolishness. You're going to see some craziness. You're going to see some outright lying spirits. Y'all don't want to hear me up in here. And you got to be a preparer. You got to be prepared because of what's going to go through your eye gate, your ear gate, and your mouth gate. And prayer is the only thing going to change this. When a man can watch 19. Slaughtered, not order the police on the premises, not order the police to go in till 19 people are dead, children, two teachers are dead, and come back the next day, lie about what happened, total lie. These are the people in authority. That's why you got to pray for your nation. You got to pray for your community because the people who are in charge are corrupt. Now we're not talking about the killer and all he did. We're talking about the corruptness of the authorities. We're in bad shape. We're in bad times. And the only thing to change this is prayer. I prayed about my heart to God last week. You know, sometimes when people mess up and they're on the opposite side of something, some type of competition, you be glad they messed up. But you can't be glad with this stuff. This stuff too serious. You can't be glad with this. You got to pray for others. We in a bad way. Oh, that sound like Doomsday Dawson, don't I? But God, if we give it to God, he said, whatever you bind on earth, isn't that what he said, sister? Whatever you bind on earth, he'll bind in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, he'll loose in heaven. God gave me revelation on that a couple of years ago. God ain't going to do nothing we won't do for ourselves. If we bind it, he'll bind it. He's not just going to come down here and bind it, and we won't bind it. We fine with it. God will let it go on until Jesus come back. But if we want to shake the foundation, we got to bind gun violence. We got to bind the spirit of affliction. We got to bind addiction. We got to bind these things and loose his anointing in the earth. That's our job. Your job is not to just sit up in the pews on Sunday. Your job is to take what you get out of here and go out in that sin-sick world and heal somebody. Are you going to pray with me? Come on, stand. So, don't despise small beginnings. I want to share something with you. On Friday night, I went to an awards banquet, and I want to thank First AB because y'all helped us stay alive. First AB allowed Deacon Louder to drive the van for some of our early programs, and I knew God would bless. Started our soccer outreach program as something to affect black males' graduation rate from high school. And like I said, Deacon Louder's gone on trips to Savannah with us and brought kids to Brunswick to participate. And so he's done some great things. So on Friday, we had 5 male college graduates at our awards banquet. Isn't that good? We had a Hispanic young man who is now the soccer coach at Brunswick High School. We had a young Caucasian young man who now works for DNR. We had 3 black males who are all working, and one had an accounting degree, one had a business degree, think of what the other one was. But we had a diverse group of young men that over our 18 years of this program, just like when I was here with you, the same time period this stuff has happened, graduated from college. Long story short, they brought myself and the other 2 gentlemen who started the program, they brought us some caps. Over the last 6 years, all these caps represent colleges that our kids have gotten scholarships to and gone to. I got 10 caps up here. 10. We started out with a $40,000 a year budget, 1 employee. Now we got 7 employees and a $400,000 a year budget. God. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? We were 3 men. We were three men, instead of paying $2,400 for each one of our children to play in a league on the island, we decided we take our $2,400. I would take care of five kids. The other coach would take care of five kids and the other kids with our money. That's how we invested it. So it has gone from that little $7,500 investment, it has gone from that to serving over 200 kids per year and 10 colleges having our children. God will do it if you pray. We got some land over here we're supposed to build on. We got a building across the street that we're supposed to do something for the community with. But it begins with the foundation of prayer. If we pray right, God will bless it right. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? We pray right, God will bless it right. So on Friday, I got to give those young men some Darius Slay, who's one of our big donors, bought them some watches. Those watches had to cost about $600. If you pray, trying to help somebody today, stop looking at what you don't have. What you don't have doesn't determine what you're going to have. If God can take nothing and make something out of it, he surely can take the little bit. Come on, somebody. You got to believe in your purpose. Our purpose is to impact this community. Our purpose is to impact the families that are part of this ministry. Somebody told me, he the mayor now. He told me the soccer wouldn't last. The mayor. He was a basketball man. A lot of people can't receive something different like that. And in some instances, it don't. Because if you're not there to work with it, to nurture it, it won't. But there has to be commitment. When we commit, God will bless. If we commit, God will bless. Can we commit to our annex? Can we commit to our community center? That means that when Pastor ain't around, you working on that thing. You working on people investing. You working on people being a part of it. Don't despise small beginnings. Amen? Let us bow our heads. Father, we come now knowing that you are a heart fixer and a mind regulator. Fix our hearts today. Start with me. Start with me, God. Fix my heart today, God. Guide our minds, God. Give us this wisdom, God, to carry out the projects, the missions of your ministry. We give this ministry to you today, God. We want prayer lines. We want prayer warriors manning those prayer lines. We want a health center. We want night school. We want special events in our building. In our new building, we want theatrical capabilities. Top of the line audio, video system. We want to be able to stream our message and our programming. We asking you now, God, we standing on faith. We refuse to despise small beginnings. We see a facility filled with people giving you the glory, giving you the praise. We can't do nothing without you. And then now, God, we pray for our nation. We pray for others today. Ooh, Jesus. right there. I want you to get right there. I want you to get outside of you. I want you to get outside of you. I got to get outside of me when I'm in prayer. Pray for others today, God. Oh, my God. Thank you, God. We pray for families in need. We pray for the homeless. Pray for those in war-torn lands. We pray for those behind prison bars. We pray for others today, God. And this week, God, as this nation goes through another spectacle, we ask you to be involved. Yeah. We ask you to be involved. In the name of Jesus. We ask you to touch now, God. Even as there are going to be injuries in the heart, some people are not going to like, God, we ask you to bless them. We ask you to keep them now, God, in your keeping care. Father, we have a prayer list here. We're going to pray for the Hargrove family, the hour of bereavement. Pray for Sister Alice Clark's family, Riles' family, right here in our church, Louder family, right here in our church. Bless them. We pray for the family of Brother Frankie Lee and the Jones family. Pray for Sister Geneva Jones. In Jesus' name. Pray for Sister Lisa James and Brother Joseph Stewart, Sister Margaret and Brother Johnny Alvin, in the name of Jesus. Pray for Sister Joanne Bacon, Brother M.P. Alvin, Brother Carl McCray, Sister Alma Wilson, Sister Kareem Williams. Touch now, God. Oh, Father, we looked around and everything looked good. Oh, my God. It looked good because you in it, God. The Bible says, oh, taste and see that the Lord, he is good. And his mercy endures forever. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen. Come on, give God some praise. Come on, give God some praise. He's worthy. He's worthy.